What's up, friends? I'm Riff, and today, with the help of one of my favorite friends, favorite YouTube channels out there, Nes Complex, please make sure and check them out. I promise you won't be disappointed. We're gonna take a look at five video games that made their way onto Nintendo consoles that you should never let small children play. Please, if you have small children, maybe don't even show them some of this. Let's start with a game that has some of the best visual presentations out there, and that's Mad World on the Wii. Mad World is a hack and slash video game developed by Platinum Games and published by Sega in 2009. I remember first seeing footage for this game and being blown away by the art style, the cartoonish black and white drawing style vibe of the game, but the blood and the gore sticking out like crazy, and then it really set in. This is a game on the Nintendo Wii.
Join us next time, Death Fans, at the Games Convention in the Deutschland!
Yeah, there is a plot to the game about a virus and a game show and blah blah blah, but the game was basically made to extract as much blood as possible from everything the game as fast as possible. And yeah, I love the game. I love the game a lot. I actually highly recommend it. Regardless of the game being unlicensed, Chiller has made its way onto the Nintendo Entertainment System. The game came out in 1990 and is a light gun game that consists of you roaming through different dungeon horror settings that will blow your mind. The game has you roaming around, shooting different environments and shooting different people, and although it sounds silly because it's on an 8-bit console, somehow it still manages to be extremely gruesome and extremely dissettling inside of your heart when playing the game. There are 5 total levels in the game: the torture chamber, the rack room, the hallway, the graveyard, and a bonus room if you unlock it correctly. I promise, this game is extremely disturbing and feels extremely immoral despite the graphics. If you have small children around, don't let them play Chiller. I promise, they won't sleep well that night.
999, or 9 hours, 9 persons, 9 doors, is definitely not for kids. It says Nintendo DS, so it ought to be great, right? Many unsuspecting parents probably walked by and said, "Oh, that looks sweet. That looks like an RPG set in modern times. I'm sure Johnny will love that." Wrong. This M in the corner should have been a warning sign. The game is graphic, bloody, violent. The women hardly wear anything at all. The story has elements of abduction, sadism, abuse, and murder. Is it fun? Yeah, actually it is. Just don't tell your kids. The game is really fun. It combines elements of choose your own adventure storytelling with escape room puzzles. And what makes it even worse, or better, is that it had 2 sequels. Don't tell your kids about these ones either.
And now, despite being one of the cutest looking games out there, Conker's Bad Fur Day appeared on the Nintendo 64 in 2001. When this game came out, platforming was at an all-time peak. It was what everybody wanted, and Conker's Bad Fur Day definitely kept that going and kept our expectations met. Despite that, there's not much to say about this game making it on this list other than it's riddled with crude humor, strong animal sexuality, tons of potty talk, and a drunken mascot who seems to disrespect everything that comes in its path.
Well, actually, he's had a very good night, but when Conker wakes up, he has no idea where he is.
Can you help me?
And with that said, the game is actually really fantastic, but the reason I don't want them playing the game for the most part is because kids tend to repeat what they hear, and what they hear in this game is tons of disrespect and snarky comments and snarky attitudes, and I don't want my kids repeating that to, say, their teachers, other adults, and especially back to me. So, Conker's for my kids. They can play it when they're older. The other day, I was listening to the song Mind Games by John Lennon, and when I started thinking about mind games and actual messing with my brain, I thought of one game, Eternal Darkness on the GameCube. A game with very similar mechanics to that of the Resident Evil games, but the game was able to distinguish itself as a unique title with the use of its sanity effects. Now, I don't think any small children should be playing this game because I know a child's brain is precious, and what this game does is mess the heck with your brain. The game plays tricks on you, nearing the point of insanity, well, hence the sanity meter and the sanity effects. The events that take place in this game not only cause you to really question what's going on in the actual game and cause you to go a little crazy, but it also takes it to a level outside of the game, your physical realm. It makes you really what's going on with your psychic and also what's going on with your actual video game hardware. The dark tone here in the game does not really worry me so much for a small child, as it's kind of expected in a game like this. But the level of mind games and tricks it will play on your head is something I need to keep my small kids away from, because they have enough to worry about and they have enough going on in their brains at such a small age. And with that, let me know what games appeared on Nintendo platforms that you have kept your small children away from, or if you did, that you would keep them away from. And again, thank you to Nes Complex, a very close friend of mine. Please go check out his channel. And if you think he hasn't posted in a while, don't worry. I know a secret. There may be some videos coming. All right, you guys, make sure and like the video. I really appreciate it. Also, subscribe if you want to see more videos 5 days a week. Have a good one. Thank you so much for watching Superhero Game Squad. Adios.